And we don't want to let our brothers and sisters down in their spiritual battles. We need to be there for them and support them and be right up there with them. And this goes to anyone that you agree with, that you think is on our side and fighting the same cause. Support those people, whoever it is. Members of the church, leaders, whoever it is. You know, one of the things that's damaging to do, and this is something, I don't think people are doing this as much anymore. But I was even guilty of this. I remember going out soul winning when I first started going to Faith Forward Baptist Church. Because it was hard preaching was so foreign to me. I loved it. Don't get me wrong. I loved it. I loved every single minute of it. Every single second of it. I still love it. It's great. But it was so foreign because I wasn't hearing it from anywhere that it seemed extreme and radical and just, you know, out there. And even when I'd go out soul winning, I'd tell people, you know, it's kind of trying to prep them to like get used to it. But that's not the right attitude to have. Because there's really nothing abnormal at all about God's word. There's nothing extreme about this. Like the people who should be, you know, a concern about how anyone might think is the world and the wickedness of this world. And you know, people like that, people who are promote wickedness, they're the ones that ought to be scared and ashamed or concerned even. Even not scared or ashamed, but just concerned about what other people might think. We ought not to care what other people, you don't need to give anyone a disclaimer before they come. And be, oh, just to let you know, he might say something that's offensive or might, you know, like you don't need to give those disclaimers for if someone's preaching the word of God. And especially when attacks are coming against the man of God, don't be embarrassed or ashamed of that. And oh, I don't want to have anything to do with those people. You know, there were a few people that when the news media came at Faith Forward Baptist Church, they didn't want to be seen on the TV cameras and stuff, and they tried to distance themselves from having anything to do with them, with us, with Pastor Anderson. But those are the most important times. See, some people, they'll go for a little while and then come back. It's because they don't want to be, you know, associated with that. And, you know, I don't want to have all that attention on me. But what they're doing is, it's like they're retreating from the battle and they're just letting their leader to go out and die. Like, don't do that. don't leave that. That is the very moment that you need to be there even more. That's the moment when Pastor Jimenez needed his friends and his supporters more than ever is when all that stuff went down with the Orlando nightclub. And all the media is attacking him and everyone's going against him. Pastor Logan Robertson right now needs people more than ever to stand up with him. So he doesn't just look alone, because I'll tell you what, it's going to, the people who hate God are going to have a field day if everyone just backs away from him. Especially those that actually believe and what he's doing and agree with him, but you're afraid to get out there on the front lines. Don't do that. He needs you now more than ever. Everyone should be standing up and saying, yep, I agree 100%. Islam's a wicked religion. Muhammad was a pedophile. Yes, a pedophile. He consummated a marriage with a 9-year-old. That's a pedophile. And it's a wicked religion. We don't back down from that. And I don't care if people don't say things exactly the same way that you might say them. If they're preaching God's word and if they're standing for the truth and they're boldly proclaiming it, support them. They need your support. Be out there with them. There's a battle going on all over the place. There's all kinds of battles. We need to stay with them.